CS2 came and brought with it many changes when it comes to workshop items. I've already created an end-to-end tutorial about making skins, so if you haven't watched it yet, make sure that you do. In today's video, we'll go over sprays and how to create them. Luckily, creating sprays doesn't need much besides an idea and an implementation of that idea, also known as a drawing. However, there are a few things that we should know, and I'll go over those in this video. As a demonstration for this tutorial, I'll be using my CTcide spray. For those who know me will know that for some reason I hate CTs, so making this spray was just a matter of time. But for those who prefer playing as a CT, don't worry, I also made a Terroristicide spray as well. Links to both items is in the description. If you like them, then please take a moment to cast your positive vote. I created the images using Inkscape, which is a great tool for creating vector drawings. Vector drawings are drawings that consist of basic shapes such as circles, polygons, and curves. The great advantage in vector drawings is the fact that they can be scaled up and down without any loss of quality. However, in this video, I will not go over the creation of the image itself, but I will show how to turn it into a spray. The resolution of the image is 1024 by 1024. I saw that the examples that Valve provided had this resolution, so I took it as a sign that this is what we should submit. So as usual, I'll fire up GIMP and load my image in it to make some changes. First, I'll add some transparency to the image so that when applied, it will look like a spray and not like a sticker. I'll start with the smoke part. First, I will save the color of the smoke using the color pick tool. Then I'll select the color, remove it, and replace it with a shape gradient that goes from the original gray color to transparent. I'll proceed with the transparency of the rest of the image in a bit, but before that, I'll move on to the next part. For every spray, we need to create two versions, our original image and another one that looks like it's dripping. So in this stage, I already have half the work done, and now we'll only need to create the dripping version, so I'll duplicate this layer. I'll rename the first layer, No Drips. Now we'll use the second layer to create the dripping version. And one way to do that is by using the smudge tool. Set the size of the brush to a suitable size and start dragging the areas you want dripping. Besides dragging the paint, you can also try and make the tips a bit rounded, which will give a more realistic drips look. You can add drips anywhere in the image, but my artistic choice was to keep the drips below the can. Okay, so now we have our drips ready. Let's go back to adding transparency to the can. One way you can do so is by choosing the eraser tool, set the opacity to a low value, and start erasing the image. But an easier way to do it is to create a mask for the relevant area and paint it with a bright gray color so that it will have transparency but still be visible. So let's do that. I exported a version of the image without the smoke in order to help me select the can easier. When you create digital art, it's always a good idea to create different components in different layers in order to be able to export its parts separately. So I'll drag the smokeless image to GIMP, select the empty area of the image, and reverse the selection by pressing Ctrl+I. And now I have the can selected. I will also select the drips using the rectangle selection. It doesn't have to be precise, I just want to include them in the mask. Now that the selection is ready, I can create and paint the mask. Right-click on the layer and choose Add Layer Mask and choose the white option. As I said earlier, I'll choose a very bright gray color, otherwise the spray will be too transparent and hard to see. Make sure that the layer mask is selected and color the selected area using the fill tool. And now the image has a subtle transparency added to it. Now we can copy this mask and add it to the No Drips layer. Let's remove the selection by pressing Ctrl+Shift+A, Then right-click on the layer mask and choose Mask to Selection. Now right-click on the No Drips layer and click on Add Layer Mask, but this time choose Selection instead of White. And there we have it. Two versions with transparency, one with drips and another clean version with no drips. All that is left for us to do is export the images as TGA files. Now pay attention because this is important. Both versions should have exactly the same name, but the version without the drips should have the suffix underscore no drips. Also make sure that you use only lowercase letters and underscores. So I'll start by exporting the dripping version. Press Ctrl+Shift+E to open the export dialog, write the name of the spray, and then click export. Now I will hide the dripping version and show the no drips layer and export again with the no drips suffix. We can now close GIMP and open the workshop item editor. We can minimize the paint and sticker folders because we'll be working only in the spray folder. Obviously, first thing we need to do is to create an entry. So I'll select the spray folder and click on the create button. I'll name it tutorial and click OK, but turns out we need to add spray underscore as a prefix for the name. Great functional decision by Valve. Anyway, we work with what we have, so let's add spray underscore to the name. Next, we'll save the entry by clicking on Save As. It's very important to save the entry under this folder or any subfolder you create in this path, otherwise you'll get an error. Another great functional decision. So I'll save the entry in this folder. Before you leave the saving dialog, make sure you copy the path because we also need to copy the TGA files to this path as well, otherwise the editor will not be able to find it. So let's open the location we've just copied and paste the TGA files there. Now we go back to the editor and click on this icon, search for the name of our image and choose the dripping version. This will automatically add both versions to the entry. From here we press the inspect button and finally we get to see our spray in action. One last thing I would like to address is the elephant in the room. It's a small elephant, but it is in the room, which is the color bleeding visible in some areas in the spray. You might get this in your sprays as well and wonder why this is happening. The answer is, I don't even have a dusty idea. The quality of my image is just perfect and lovely. I haven't scaled the image at all, so I really have no explanation here other than to blame the game itself. If anyone finds a solution to this issue, then please be a dear and write it down in the comments. And if I find out how to solve it, then I'll make a follow-up video about it. Until then, take care and see you soon.